Don't kill me!
Make sure you have the latest or one of the latest nightly versions. Open up PCSX2 and go to Settings Controllers. Here at the bottom, we are going to create a new input profile. You can name it as you like it. I'm going to name it KM Games, Keyboards and Mouse Games. Now a message will show up. Do you want to copy all bindings from the currently selected profile? Select no. This will create a profile with empty bindings, and that's what we want. In the USB port 1, select heat keyboard. In the USB port 2, select heat mouse. Here you can configure your mouse buttons. Left button, right button, and middle button. And here you can just press the left button. You can configure the controller too. Some games that support the keyboard still use the controller to navigate the menu, so you might need that. Go back to global settings. Here in the profile settings, turn on use per profile hotkeys. A new tab called hotkeys will show up here. Now click on it. And here you can configure your hotkeys like save state, pause emulation, full screen. This way you don't have to mess your controller configuration. And the PS2 hotkeys won't conflict with the in-game keyboard controls. I'm going to make a shortcut for toggle full screen, Alt F, a shortcut to pause, Control Space, and a shortcut to shut down PCSX2, Control Backlash. Now close this, search for a game with keyboard and mouse control you want to play, like Final Fantasy VII. Press the right mouse button in the game, go to properties, and here in the input profile, choose the one you just created. And then start the game. Alternatively, you can start the game and then go to settings, game properties, and choose input profile. Whenever you want to leave the emulator, you can press the hotkey that you choose to close the emulator. You can also go back to window mode and then pause the emulator. And then you can just do whatever you want. That's it for this video. Thank you for watching and happy gaming.